Hey, Sagittarius. Hopefully you guys are doing well. Happy holidays to you guys. Hopefully this season is really treating you very well. For the ones who are alone this holiday season, I send you so much love, peace, and comfort because I know it can be difficult personally, I know. So I just send you so much love and solace, you know. So let's see. Let's look into your fated event. What's your next fated event to happen and when? So for my Sagittariuses, what is their next fated event? We have you are good enough. Full moon in Virgo. Bottom of the deck is take time to breathe out. Disseminating moon. So let's go ahead and look at the time frames for this and get back into it. 1 second. Okay, so sorry about that, Sagittarius. Needed to look into the dates for this. So the next full moon in Virgo actually happens on March 18th. And then we have disseminating moon, which is normally 2 to 5 days after the full moon. So between March 18th through March 23rd, you will start to feel this energy of a fated event, or the fated event will occur, I should actually say. So let's look into this and see what this is, because if you are good enough here, there's something that... I don't know. This can go so many different ways. Let's get some more information here. But don't overthink something. Don't overthink it. Whatever this is, you are good enough. Don't overthink it. So for my Sagittarius, tell me about their next fated event. Okay, we got two here. So we have burnout. Your hard work will see results, but your health needs to be maintained. So check in with your doctor, dentist, and health professional and try to maintain a healthy lifestyle. And we have manifestations. A bountiful time awaits you. Your wishes could manifest right before your eyes. So, this is actually really, it's beautifully sad. Hopefully I can make sense of what I'm feeling here. Because Sagittarius, there's something that if you haven't started already that you will be working very hard on. You want certain results of a manifestation that you're trying to fulfill, whether this is in your career, whether it's in like a project, whether it's in your investments, whether it's something that you're very passionate about, whatever it is that you want to manifest. I see you putting in a lot of effort trying to bring it into fruition, trying to culminate that manifestation into reality. But there's a sense of you feeling burnt out. So maybe you've been trying to climb up a hill for so long, wondering, will this work out for me, right? Maybe it's not meant, or maybe, you know, it won't turn out the way I want, or why is it taking so long, you know? There's something here that has you questioning yourself. No matter what the questions are, no matter what questions you're posing to yourself, even if it's not the examples I gave you, because there are thousands of examples of self-questioning, right? But there's something here that has you in your head due to all the hard work you've been putting towards your manifestation, and you just haven't been seeing it. Well, the thing about this is here, between March 18th and the 23rd, there's something fated that happens in regards to your manifestation, something that is absolutely fated. So we'll take time to breathe out in the meantime until this fated event occurs in regards to your manifestation. Be kind on yourself. You are good enough. You are doing what you can, Sagittarius. You're putting in your best effort. And again, if you haven't started working on whatever this is, you will be before this time period of March 18th and the 23rd. And you may feel burnt out. You may be putting in tireless hours, getting up day and night, you know, overly researching, doing whatever it is that you need to do to really work on this manifestation here. But just pace yourself, right? You don't want to burn out quick. And that's what we're seeing here is burnout. So let's look further into this for you, Sagittarius. Can you tell me about Sagittarius's next fated event, Spirit? Sagittarius's next fated event. Thank you. Door to romance. Oh, I love it. Bottom of the deck is cornucopia. I thought I'll just point that out. So... Looking at this, I didn't even notice there's master numbers on here too. You got 3-3 and 11-11. So Sagittarius, through this hard work you're putting out there to really manifest something, you may start to see angel numbers. I think you and only one other sign got indicators of angel numbers. You may see angel numbers of like 11-11, 3-3-3, 10-10, 2-2-2, whatever the case may be. Just know that your angels, your spirit guides, the people who love you and they cover you from the other side, they are working alongside you to help these manifestations come into fruition. Even if you feel like you've been working tirelessly on whatever this manifestation is to come to fruition. So door to romance here. I love it. This isn't a love reading, so I'm not really going to put this in a love context unless you are trying to manifest that ideal partner or the person that you do want, or you're trying your best to work on a relationship and still feel like you're not getting anywhere, or feeling like you're not good enough for that person that you're still putting all this effort in. If that is the case, I'm just going to get this out the way. If that is the case with this door to romance, if you're trying to manifest a current connection that just is not working, no matter how hard you try, that connection is not a fated connection for you. Door to romance, this lets me know around that March time period, which March is represented by the number 3. Around that time period, more than likely you will end up meeting, 3, 3, 11, 11. When you break down the numbers, it comes to 2023. And mind you, this is between the 16th and the 23rd of March. So even more synchronicities there. The person that you are fated to meet will come in around that time frame, right? So you're putting in all this work to manifest a love situation with a certain partner. And if it's just not working, you're not feeling good enough, it's just not bringing you the results or outcomes you're looking for, there actually is somebody that's fated for you to meet around March 18th to the 23rd. Now, outside of love, because again, this isn't a love reading, with door to romance, this is something that you feel very passionate about, something you feel really connected to, something that actually will bring you the abundance. Each and every one of you will have a different version of abundance. It's very subjective, whether it's in finances, whether it's just in having peace, wholeness, whatever abundance is for you, stability. There's something that you feel really connected to on the soul level, something that you love, something that you're passionate about, something that is a driving force or factor for you. And that's happening. Again, the door is opening for this manifestation to come through. But I just see here, Sagittarius, you working so effortlessly and so tired on this thing, and not seeing the results that you're wanting or looking for. Not saying that they won't come, how can I put this? Not saying that your efforts are in vain, but it feels like this is just going to take a little bit of more time than you may have predicted or maybe that you've planned for. And it's happening in divine timing and not on your time, unfortunately. But at least we have a time frame of when to expect this manifestation to start to reveal itself or to start to show up in your reality. So tell me more about Sagittarius's next fated event. Thank you. Patience. Yeah. That's what's being asked of you here, Sagittarius, is patience. And you have it. You absolutely have the patience or the ability to have patience. Now, to utilize and exercise that is a different story, right? We all could be patient if we put our mind to it. But to actually utilize that patience and stick with it, that's when it gets more tricky. And that's what Spirit's asking you here, Sagittarius. Good things just don't come overnight, and those manifestations just don't spring up, you know, next day. But I feel like because you're just putting in so much work, you're trying, you're tired, you know, make sure you are taking care of yourself, right? That you still are eating, you know, appropriately, that you are eating enough, right? Because some of you may be working so hard that you may be slacking on meals, or you may not be eating nutritious meals. You may be eating out a lot more, eating fast food, because you have a lot of hours that you're trying to put into this thing and you don't really have the time to cook, or you're not really making the time to cook because you want to focus on really building or creating whatever this is. And for some of you, if this is a love situation that you're putting all this effort into, because you are putting all this effort into it and you're not getting anywhere with this and you're getting burnt out, you know, I think emotionally it may be suppressing your appetite, you know, and if you're dealing with appetite suppression because of the emotional tiring of this situation between you and somebody, please make sure you do take care of your health. But again, for the majority of you, since it's not a love reading, just make sure you keep a healthy lifestyle if you can. Working out, walking, getting your water in. Even if you got to get a jug that you fill up with water and you make sure you drink that entire jug by the end of the day. And you make sure you meal prep if you have to, if you don't have time to cook, to make sure that you're still in good standing with your health. Ask and receive. Very beautiful energy here, Sagittarius, because that's what I feel like you've been doing. I feel like you've been asking, when will this happen? Can we speed up the process? Can this happen like next week? Right? You've been asking, you've been praying, you've been manifesting, you've really been doing what it is. Not only, and that's, this is the thing I love about you, Sag, and I have to highlight this for you, because you haven't only just been praying and asking, but you've been putting in the work. And when you actually put in the energetic aspect of it through prayer and meditation and asking, and you're putting in the footwork, whatever it is that you are manifesting will come to reality or will come to fruition, because you're handling it on both angles, not just one. And because it says ask and receive, not just ask, that lets me know that whatever this is, you will be receiving here. And it's hard because, you know, with that manifestation card, it says a bountiful time awaits you. Your wishes could manifest right before your eyes. I can't really tell you what the exact fated event is, but I can tell you what it surrounds. It surrounds whatever it is that you're manifesting. Because it's a general reading, I have to keep it general. So you know personally, Sagittarius, what it is that you're manifesting. That specific thing, you know, that one specific thing that you're manifesting. That's what we're talking about today. So tell me more, Spirit, for my Sagittarius, in regards to the next fated event. And that thing that you're manifesting is fated to happen for you. So what's meant for you will not pass you by. That's the beautiful thing about this. This is not just like a regular what to expect. This is something that actually is fated that will change the trajectory in the course of your life. And you know this. You know whatever this is will change the course of your life. And that's why this is something that you're really manifesting, that you're really asking for and praying for. So we have pendulum. And fluctuating income and decision, new strategy, making choices, job change, right? So in this energy here, Sagittarius, for some of you, if you are trying to manifest a new job or better finances because where you're working at is just tiring you out, you're burnt out, you're putting in all these hours for little pay, or you're dedicating yourself to a company that isn't really dedicated to you, or your finances are fluctuating because of circumstances going on and you're trying to manifest a better financial situation for yourself, it is going to require a new strategy from you. So again, the way you've been going about things, if you're not seeing at least steps of progression, you may need to change the way you're going about it. For others of you, it's going to require you to make a choice. Right? If you're working somewhere or the way you're receiving finances or your investments, if it's not producing the outcomes, that moment, that fated moment for you would be making that choice, or a new opportunity arises for you to make a choice to transition or to, you know, take on a new opportunity to better your situation. For some of you, if this is a connection or a love connection that is just, you're putting in all this effort and it's not working out, you are going to have to make a choice whether you stay or leave. And if you decide to make that choice, which is that full finalized decision, what's fated for you is love that's meant for you. So let's go ahead and get one more card here for you, Sagittarius. Tell me about Sagittarius' next fated event. Sagittarius' next fated event, Spirit. Oops. Thank you. Four of Cups. Seek out other possibilities. Look for the magic in life. Be aware of your own emotions. Which is for Raphael in this deck. But bottom of the deck is the Two of Michael, right? It would all be better if you just make a decision. Overanalyzing a problem, find compromise. So Two of Swords. The beautiful part about this here, Sagittarius, is if you do have to make that decision to leave something behind or transition, realizing you're working so tirelessly or effortlessly, but with no, I don't want to say effortlessly, but working tirelessly and not seeing the results that you're looking for or the the outcomes that you're looking for, you are going to have to make that decision and seek out other possibilities. But the thing about the seek out other possibilities, I don't feel like it's necessarily something that you have to seek out. I feel like that's actually what's fated. Those possibilities that will come up, those opportunities that will come up again between March 16th and the 23rd to say, you know what, I am going to transition and go here. Or opportunities, if you are working on a business or a project or something you want to bring to life, whether it's a YouTube channel, publishing a book, writing music, you're an artist, whatever it may be, you want to start up that boutique or that business, whatever it may be, the opportunity to really take that business somewhere will come about around that time period. Or if you're on the brink of just working this job and you want to transition into your own business and it's just been tiring, then the opportunity to do so will come around that time period as well. But something is fated here. And again, I don't feel like this is necessarily possibilities you need to seek out. If you look at this, it's an angel coming in with this cup, this third cup. And that's the thing, you don't see this fated event happening. But it's almost like your angels, the divine spirit, is sending you that opportunity to bring your manifestations to life, right? Looking at all the burnout, all the tireless days and nights and effort you put in and not really seeing the results of what you wanted, just feeling disappointed, feeling maybe like you're not good enough, or the efforts you put in hasn't really reaped the rewards that you're looking for. And little do you know, here's this fated event in the background coming in for you with that actual opportunity to change your life. So, Sagittarius, it's game time. It is going to require you some patience, because even looking at this card, this girl is still looking at the cups that were lost and not seeing what's about to come in. So again, we got till March. We still got some time. But in the meantime, Sagittarius, be safe. I love you. Be well, be blessed, and take care of yourself. Bye.